Hey everyone, this is Ipar Roy and welcome to the 8th episode of Doki Doki Literature Club. We did leave off at the last part where we had a happy ending where we became a couple with Sayori and now we are dating. I guess we are dating. I mean, we just started so I don't really know what will happen in the future. But it's the day of the festival and so we get to meet Sayori again and hopefully she's doing better than last time because she was completely depressed over that. That scenario was much worse than I anticipated. I knew she was sad. I didn't know she was depressed. Depression is like a whole new level of sad. I'm sure you know what depression is, right? Anyways, so it's the day of the festival. Why can't... Of all the days, I expected this to be the one where I'd be walking home school with Sayori. But Sayori isn't answering her phone. Oh god, Sayori. Sayori. God, man. Also, Monica said something to Sayori. She said that, like, she said that Monica told her to and then she didn't finish the sentence. What did Monica say? Because I'm pretty sure she said something negative in the context that Sayori brought it up. Oh god, I consider going to her house to wake her up but decided that's a little too much. Meanwhile, the preparations for the event should be nearly complete. I managed to carry all the cupcakes myself by carefully stacking two trays. Why did you not go up to... Can I have choices in these parts, please? What the hell? Asuki is already texting up a storm, but I can't respond thanks to my hands being full. Funnily enough, I probably feel the same way as Asuki about the event. I'm more excited for it to be over so I can spend time with Sayori and Asuki about the fest and Asuki at the festival. So you want to spend time with both now? But knowing Monica, I'm sure the event will go great too. Please go talk to Sayori, please. Riro, don't be a douchebag. You left Sayori at home. Riro, you're the first one here. Okay, I'm gonna do that girly voice just to like change up so that even if you guys are not reading along, you know who's talking. Thanks for being early. That's funny. I thought at least Yuri would be here by now. Monica is placing little booklets on each of the desks in the classroom. They must be the ones she prepared that have all the poems we're performing. In the end, I found a random poem online that I thought Monica would like and submitted it. So that's the one I'll be performing. I'm surprised you didn't bring Sayori with you. Yeah, she overslept again. That dummy. You'd think on all the days that important, she'd try a little harder. I say that, but I suddenly... Exactly. What a dick. I say that, but I suddenly remember what Sayori told me yesterday. And I suddenly feel awful, knowing that it's not really that simple for her. I only said it because it's the way I'm used to thinking. But maybe I should have gone to wake her up after all. Yes. That's a smart move to do, Riro. You're not smart at all. You be dumb. Riro, be dumb. Okay, you should take a little responsibility for her, Riro. I mean, especially after your exchange with her yesterday. You kind of left her hanging this morning, you know. How does she know? Exchange? Monica, you know about that? Of course I do. I'm the club president, after all. That doesn't explain anything. But, I stammer, embarrassed. Did Sayori really tell her about it that quickly? That we are a couple now? I didn't really plan to bring it up with anything yet. Jeez. You don't know the full story at all, so... Don't worry. I probably know a lot more than you think. Eh? Monica is being as friendly as usual, but for some reason I felt a little chill down my spine after hearing that. Monica, what you hiding? What did you tell Sayori the other day? Hey, do you want to check out the other pamphlets? They came out really nice. Yeah, sure. I grab all the pamphlets I laid out on the desk. Oh yeah, they really did. Something like this will definitely help people take the club more seriously. Yeah, I thought so too. I flipped through the pages. Each member's poem is neatly printed on its page, giving it an almost professional feel. I recognized Natsuki's and Yuri's poems from the one they performed during our practice. What's this? I flipped to Sayori's poem. It's different from the one she practiced. It's the one I haven't read before. Oh god, wait, what? Oh shit. Get out of my head. Get out of my head before I do what I know is best for you. Get out of my head before I listen to everything she said to me. Get out of my head before I show you how much I love you. Get out of my head before I finish writing this poem. But a poem is never actually finished. It just stops moving. I also noticed during this entire time the music hasn't started. Also, I'm getting goosebumps. Oh god. Goosebumps, why? Do you know something I don't? Well, this is bad. What the hell? I should go check on somebody. Oh god, what is this? Reading the poem, I get a pit in my stomach. Riro? What's wrong? Nothing. This poem feels completely different from everything else Sayori has written. But more than that, I changed my mind. I'm going to get Sayori, so... Ah, well, alright. Try not to take too long, okay? Oh god, please be okay, Sayori. I quickly, don't strain yourself. Marika calls that out after me. I quickened my pace. Sayori, what was I thinking? I should have tried a bit harder for Sayori. It's not a big deal to at least wait for her or help her wake up. Even the simple gesture of waking her to school makes her really happy. Besides, I told her yesterday that things will be the same as they always have been. That's all she needs. That's what I want to give her. Please be okay, Sayori. I reach Sayori's house and knock on the door. I don't expect an answer. She's not picking up on her phone either. Like yesterday, I opened the door and let myself in. Sayori? She really is a heavy sleeper. I swallow. Oh god, I can't believe I end up doing this after all. Waking her up in her own arms. That really is something a boyfriend would do, isn't it? In any case, it just feels right. Outside Sayori's room, I knock on her door. Sayori? Wake up, dummy. There's no response.
Why?
Oh god, I'm extremely tense right now. Oh god, there's no response. I really didn't want to have to enter her room like this. Isn't it some kind of breach of privacy? But she really leaves me no choice. I gently open the door. An exception has occurred. A file game script ch5.rpy line 307. Set traceback.txt for details. See traceback.txt.
What the hell?
It's because I didn't wake her up, didn't I?
Oh shit, Sayori.
Can I load? Can still load, right? Should I load back?
I feel bad.
Even the music is sad.
What the hell? What the hell? Is this a nightmare? It has to be. This isn't real. There's no way this can be real. Sayori wouldn't let me do this.
I'm gonna save at this point. Hold on. I wanna finish off this slot and then try and see if I can come back to it.
Sayori won't do this. Everything was normal up until a few days ago. That's why I can't believe what my eyes are showing me.
I suppressed the urge to vomit. Just yesterday, I told Sayori I would be there for her. I told her what's best. And that everything will be okay. Then why? Why would she do this? How could I be so helpless? What did I do wrong? Confessing to her? I shouldn't have confessed to her.
Is that true? Is that not? Oh god.
But I thought she liked me.
Oh god, did I make the wrong choice? Did I even save at that point? I didn't save again, did I?
Oh god, why am I not saving at these points? This is bad. That's not what Sayori needed at all. Even if she told me how painful it is for others to care about her, then why did I confess to her and make her feel even worse? Why was I so selfish? This is all my fault. My swarming thoughts kept telling me everything I could have done to prevent this. If I just spent more time with her, walked her to school and remained friends with her, like it always has been, then I could have prevented this.
Yeah, she did say that she wants things to be as it was and we were friends.
Come on, man. Did I make a bad choice?
I don't know. I didn't save.
It has 9 save slots. 9 to 6. What is that? 54 save slots, and I still didn't save.
Oh god, why? I knew I could have prevented this. Screw the literature club. Screw the festival. I just
Lost my best friend, someone I grew up with. She's gone forever now. Nothing I can do to bring her back. This isn't a game where I can reset and try something different. I can. I already had one chance, and I wasn't careful enough. And now I'll carry this guilt with me until I die. Nothing in my life is worth more than hers. But I still couldn't do what she needed me from me, and now I can never take it back. Never. 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 Okay. The game has not ended, has it? You see how Seori is broken? What the hell? New game? I see an annoying girl running toward me from the distance, waving her arms in the air like she's totally oblivious to any attention she might draw to herself. The girl is my neighbor and good friend. She's we. Oh god, the. Like her existence has been deleted from the game. Oh wow. You know the kind of friend you never see us making today? We just kind of worse out because you know each other for so long. We used to walk, okay, but she's running away. And let. Yeah, the name is complete. Meanwhile, I've always walked to school alone. Okay, so the player's memory is being replaced. Great, so the horror has kicked in. Good to know, I have goosebumps already. Well, shit. I myself, I meet some girls or something like that, but I have no motivation to join any clubs. I'm perfectly content just getting by on the average while spending my free time on games and anime. There's an anime club, but there won't be girls in it anyway, so... The school day is already as ever. Over before I know it, pack my things, on some motivation clubs. Really, and no interest. Besides, most of them would be too demanding. Guess no choice but to start with the anime club. Rito? What is happening? Monica? Oh my goodness, I didn't expect to see you here. It's been a while, right? Yeah, it has. Monica smiles sweetly. We don't know each other. Well, we rarely talk, but we were in the same class as last year. Oh god. Burps and hiccups everywhere. Okay, Monica was probably the most popular girl in class, smart, beautiful, athletic. Besides, basically, completely out of my league. So having her smile at me so genuinely feels a little... What did you come in here for anyway? Oh, I've just been looking for some supplies to use for my club. Do you know if there's any construction paper in here? Or markers? I guess you could check the closet. You're in the debate club, right? Aha, about that. I actually quit the debate club. Really? You quit? Yeah. To be honest, I can't stand all the politics around major clubs. This is the same dialogue she used when we met everyone in the literature club, didn't we? It feels like nothing about budget and publicly, okay? Make special with club literature dinner. Oh, I'm starting a new one. What happened? Why did that glitch? A literature club. Literature? That sounds kind of dull. How many members do you have so far? It's kind of embarrassing, but there's only three of us so far. Wait, so is Seori? There were Yuri, Seori, and Natsuki. Three of us? It's really hard to find new members for something that sounds so boring. Well, I can see that. It's not really boring, you know? Literature can be anything, reading, poetry, writing. I mean, one of the members keeps changing her manga collection in the club. That's Natsuki. Wait, really? Yeah, it's funny, right? She always insists the manga is literature too. I mean, she's not wrong, I guess. But basically, a member's a member, right? Did Monica say she? Are you that much of a dick? Hey, Rito, by any chance, are you still looking for a club to join? I guess so, but in that case, is there any chance you could do me a big favor? I would ask you to join, but if you could at least visit my club, it would make me really happy. please. Well, I guess I have no reason to refuse. Besides, I could refuse someone like Monica. Sure, I guess I could check it out. Ah, oh, awesome. She did say three. I want to check that out. Who's the third member? Really sweet, you know that? It's nothing, really. Shall we go then? And look for some materials on the other time. You're more important. And thus, today marks the day I sold my soul to Monica and her irresistible smile. Huh. This seems like... Yeah, I did a good job starting a new game trailer. The game has not ended at all. I'm back and I brought a guest with me. Hey? A guest? Seriously, you brought a boy? Way to kill the atmosphere, don't be mean, Natsuki. But anyway, welcome to the club, Rito. All words escape me in this situation. This club is full of incredibly cute girls. So let me guess, you're Monica's boyfriend, right? What? No, I'm not. Didn't she say it was Sayori's boyfriend once? Okay. So the entire game has been rewritten. But she did say three. Oh, wait, three of them. Oh. Okay, yeah, she's right. Okay, there were three of them. Why did I not think Monica is a member? Ah, okay. So from four of them, it's gone down to three of them. It's nice to meet both of you. So I ran to Rito in class soon. Isn't that great? Wait, Monica, didn't I tell you advice? Well, I was, sorry. I should make some tea, right? Sit down, Rito. So this is all, again, the same dialogue from the first part of the game. But everything except, like, Sayori's has been completely deleted from the universe, from this game universe. Oh. Is that what that file exception was when she killed herself? Maybe. I don't know. I feel bad though. I can still go back and reload, right? Oh. Oh wait, did I, when I started a new game, did I override all my saves? Eh. Okay, well shit, I didn't expect that. Okay, I didn't think of that. Aspirant, duty, surprise, more people, must be hard. Could put it that way, interesting, blah blah blah, blah bloom bloom, bleem 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 bleem. Hey, Natsuki, well, I guess Natsuki gave these. Just skipping down, this is like the same thing that everyone had before, so I'm just gonna skip past this. Natsuki's still the same, she still perked up when I said manga. Anything that I'm missing out on? Nope, not a bunch, nothing at all. Still read a horror book once, suits your personality. Something, surreal horror. Why horror? Well, I just Natsuki dot, so never mind. What? Don't say it out loud. Give it back. Fine, what do you care? It's impressive. New, ever size, you won't like them. Not a confident. Sharing, something. I'm just quick reading, okay, guys? So just excuse me while I quickly go through this entire thing. What's that? We reached the most important topic, but I've already came forth. I never said I want to join this club. Monica has been convinced to stop by, but I never made any decision. So I really have a look at it. I lost my train of thought. All the three girls stared back at me with dejected eyes. Aww. I'm sorry, I thought. Truth. Hey, she's glad before Monica turns back to me. I guess you need to tell the truth, you know. The thing is, we have members to form an official club. We need four. Shaori was the fourth member. She was the vice president. Who's the vice president now? There's no vice president in this club anymore, does it? Ew. Shit. Well, I joined the literature club. Again, I guess. Oh wait, is the game gonna end on me like this again? Oh god. Oh wow, I think I know why this game is a psychological horror. Oh. Do you know a guy killed himself after playing this game? I can guess why. Like the personality development on this game is phenomenal. If you try to get to know one person, like the development around that one girl is phenomenal. Got attached to Sayori. I feel bad. So we are an official club. Apart, make my way home. Find Vanessa, Natsuki, Yuri, of course Monica, and no Sayori. Why? I just need to make more, and it's the same thing. Sure, I would like to leak it, yes. A dream. I was staying over at my friend's place. There were four of us. I drifted off to sleep while everyone was talking and watching TV. In my dream, I was still at my friend's house. The only difference was that there were nails sticking out of the walls everywhere. And there was also someone I didn't recognize. The person I didn't recognize told a joke and everyone laughed. I woke up to the sound of everyone laughing at something that happened on the TV. So the laughing was not part of the dream. It was a noise that woke me up. I wonder who that person was and how they knew to tell a joke at that moment. Yeah, okay, cool. I'm gonna leave this episode here. Oh god, a lot happened in this episode. Anyways, well, Sayori's gone. It is my fault, isn't it? I'm gonna save. Yeah, I'm gonna save here. Anyway, I'm out of time for today, so no more. I recorded the last episode in the same setting, so I'm out of time for today in general. God, this game became interesting and depressing at the same time. Shit. Yeah, I don't know what to say. Damn, that Sayori's death caught me off guard. I thought I had an happy ending. And then the moment I didn't go check on her the morning, like this morning, the day of the festival, I knew something was wrong. Shit. Okay, so guess whatever I do, I think I had to lose Sayori in the end. Okay, so I guess I will end the episode here, okay? So thank you so much guys for watching. If you predicted that ending, hit the like button. If you didn't predict that ending, please subscribe to my channel. And I'm being really cheap right now. It's not something to be. Anyway, so thank you so much guys for watching. I hope you liked the video. This is Reaper Rai signing out. Bye bye.